you hate people, but only sometimes? If so, you might be an introvert. Hi. So, the whole entire internet this week has just decided to inform the youth on going back to college content. Did that make any sense? No. I have seen like 15 videos this week recommended to me of like, what I wish I knew before I was a freshman, and I've already made one of those videos. So I'm making it again, but a little more niche. I'm so sorry. I actually look like such a mess in this video. My hair is wet. I took a shower. I was having a self-care day today. You know, it was my day off. So I was watching like so many video essays on YouTube about like plastic surgery and like feminism, and I painted my nails. That's self-care. So, and don't get me wrong, like in this video, I wanna make it very clear. I love people. I'm doing Alexis Rose hands. I love people. I love talking to people. I really do. But it gets very tiring for me. And I think that the transition from high school to college, it was a really big one for me in terms of like my work style, how I got papers done and homework, because your living situation is constant. Like you can't go home from college, like not really. At least I lived 10 hours, 8 hours away from home the first 2 years of college. And it's a really big transition because like there are just some times where you're just like, I need to be away from people. Like, I can't, like, everyone's always here all the time. And like, if you have drama with your roommates, like that's a whole other thing. All right, so my first tip, hide from your roommate slash roommates. Yes, so this is what I mean by this. They come into a room, you do a spy roll underneath the bed. Let's hope they have a bed skirt, because that is a really easy way to just like, you know, they can't even see you. If you hear them coming, just hide behind the door, because most of the time they'll just kind of like grab something and then leave, right? No, I'm just kidding. Don't hide from your roommates. I'm going to admit something that's a little bit embarrassing, okay? I'm a stalker. No, I'm not. Just kidding. This tip is going to help you. And I think that it's just human nature. It's not weird. I'm not a stalker. No, I'm not. But one thing that is like really important when you have a roommate is to, and you're an introvert, like is knowing when you can have alone time. Notice your roommate's schedule. Don't like figure out, like, don't like, like, obviously don't like ask. Well, you could actually, you could probably ask for a copy of their schedule. You could, if you swap schedules, you could do that. Especially when you're like living in a room with another person. Like, I think that alone time is like so very necessary. Yeah, and it's definitely important to communicate like what you are doing with your roommate too, because, you know, maybe they want some alone time, because everyone needs a minute sometimes, you know? Everyone needs a sec. Okay. And it's sometimes you can feel like very like judged, like when you go in your freshman year to like have alone time, and it's like it can be really overwhelming when there's like 8 people living with you and everyone wants to like tell, especially the girls, like, oh my gosh. Cause we love to share the tea. We love to give the tea. We love to just like update people on our lives. Like, and it's so fun. Like, I'm not gonna get you wrong. It's so fun. But then there are some times where like you really have to do something and then like they're telling you this great story and like you want to be invested, but like the whole time you're just thinking about like the paper you have to write that's due tomorrow at 8 a.m. And as an 18-year-old, sometimes it's hard to be like, hey, stop talking. I have to go do work, because like you don't wanna be that person. And if you know in your heart that you're not gonna communicate those things, so hide from your roommates, okay? So we're just gonna move on to number two. So number two is do not be afraid of doing things alone. Okay, so I feel like college is just like high school trauma, like relived like the first year. If we're all gonna be honest with each other, like no one wants to sit in the dining hall alone. And there's definitely a stigma about that, like only in your head, because never, not one time have I looked at a person eating alone and been like, damn, they look depressed. They look sad. They don't have friends. Never have I once done that. Not one time. Most people aren't gonna notice you, especially if you're going and doing things alone, because sometimes you just have class or you're busy and you want to go sit somewhere and get some work done. And I definitely had like a complex about that my freshman year of college. Like it took a lot for me to go and do things on my own, especially living like in a new city by myself. Like I was like, I can't go to like a coffee shop by myself. You can, newsflash. But my sophomore year, when I had like so much work to do, I would basically just bring my laptop or whatever to the library or to a Starbucks and just like order like a coffee or something and sit upstairs. And I would get so much work done. Honestly, sometimes the pressure of like a crowd of people like judging me, they're not judging me, but like I play this game in my head where I'm like, they're judging you, so you have to write faster. Okay. Anyway, so I found this article on University College of London. They wrote an article, someone named Miriam Clark, a student at University of College of London. She calls us little introverts in this. All right, yeah, we can be little introverts together, guys. We can. So I'm just gonna read through some of the advice that she gives and give my own opinion. So the first number one is know your social strengths and embrace them. Okay, introverts tend to be great leaders, quietly mentoring those around us with patience and encouragement. With our attention to detail and time we spend thinking things through, we also tend to be quite eloquent writers. Embrace these qualities and have your voice heard by writing articles or even running sabbatical positions. You can do it, my little introvert. Okay. Thanks, Miriam. So actually, I think that this is pretty good advice. While that was just like boasting about introverts a little bit, which no one needs to tell me how awesome we are because I know. But that's definitely true. I joined like her campus, which is like at most college campuses. And it was a really fun like outlet for me to like share my voice and my opinions because I would like write these online articles. It was fun. I got to like meet some people through there and write my weird articles about the trauma of being a college freshman. So yeah, I think that that's actually a really good piece of advice. Okay, number two, let go of the idea that you're missing out. Saying no to a social event because you'd rather spend time in your room with your cat, dog, goldfish to recharge is not a bad thing to do. So what if you're missing out on the latest hot gossip? Your well-being comes first. And then she wrote, hashtag no regrets. Oh my God, thanks, Miriam. So true. That's definitely for real. I actually relished in when my roommates would go out without me after a while. Cause like at first I was like, I'm so tired. Like I can't go. And then like I would feel bad and I would be like, I'm so sad, like I'm missing the party. Obviously like don't do that all the time. Like you should talk to people. But if there is a chance for you to like be alone in your dorm room with nobody there with you, like that's definitely like a necessary evil sometimes. It's not even evil because as an introvert, like that's so much fun. Like I love being alone. Okay, number seven, skip the small talk. Yeah, that's so true. Guys, I hate small talk. There, I said it. I hate it. Like, why would I talk about the weather when we could talk about your past trauma? Or my past trauma? I don't know. Like, that's what I want to do. I don't really want to hear about the weather or like anything like that. Do I want to hear like the moment that shaped you as a child into the person you are today? Like, yes, I want to hear that. I want to hear that so badly for everybody. And that's maybe an issue, but oh my God, I hate small talk. And then that's what, like, makes like parties kind of hard and draining because it's like all small talk. Unless it like at the beginning, unless you like know the people, but like, yeah, that can be definitely hard as a freshman to be like, hey, like what class? What's your major? Because like every time I have to answer that question or I have to ask that question because like sometimes you can't think of anything. So like you do end up asking the person like, what's your major? Like, you know, it's just like a little piece of you dies and with the other person too. I think like it's a collective death of the pieces of us. Number eight, stay true to yourself. So true, Miriam. It's going to become exhausting for you as an introvert. Ignore your need for it's going to become exhausting if you as an introvert ignore your need for solitude. Even if this means having a mini fridge in your room so that you can have quiet, undisturbed night in, do it. Offer yourself the care you need to be 100% you and you will have a much more enjoyable university experience. That is definitely so true. Like, I think that it's so easy to get wrapped up, especially as college freshmen nowadays, like in social media and, you know, so many people have something to say online or showing what they're doing. And, you know, not everybody is fulfilled or happy in the same ways. So, you know, I say this every time, but you know, comparison's bad. So don't do that, but don't do that. Do not compare yourself to others, which I definitely did. So I don't really know how to help you there because I have been inside the mind of an 18, 19 year old and all you do is compare yourself online to other people. But yeah, I think that all that advice was very interesting. And yeah, I think that it's important to talk about these things because I didn't even think about the fact that I was an introvert before I went to college, really. And I kind of wish that I had because it would have saved me like feeling bad about it, I guess. because sometimes in those nights alone where I was like having like a great time by myself because like I needed it, I would be like, well, damn, I'm not like out being a party lady. And I should have just, you know, been okay with those nights and enjoyed them and not have stressed, because you will meet people and, you know, you got to put yourself out there, and that will include going to things that like you don't like. But thank you so much for watching. If you made it all the way to the end of this, I post new videos every Thursday, and go follow me on Instagram if you haven't already. It will be linked down below. It's like Katie Blake 7 or something like that. And comment down below if you're an introvert who went to college. Like, comment down your hot tips, and please tell me that I am not the only one who like tries to hide from their roommate sometimes. Like, because sometimes like you don't want to like say it, you know, you just want to like, you just want to skedaddle. Ba, ba, da, ba, ba.